I think I maybe owe Travis Scott an apology. Yes. I was watching the fucking Circus Maximus performance, the live show that he did in Rome, Italy, you know, put on a show to celebrate his album Utopia. And I said on here on the podcast, I didn't really enjoy the album. I haven't really enjoyed it, to be completely honest. It's not something I replay a lot, but it's fucking hard live. And if you haven't seen the video, please check it out yourself. I'm not going to play all of it, but you can see it here, the title. It's by this, it's on this channel called Matt Hawkinson, right? So it's MATTHAWKSON. And he's got a video here called Travis Scott Full Live Performance in Rome, Italy. And with brackets, Kanye West is back. And it legitimately makes the album sound 10 times better hearing him perform it live. And it's amazing too, because he did us a fucking pleasure. He did us a fucking favor. And he actually performed the album. Because a lot of these motherfuckers will go and perform their fucking rap albums at these shows and just be screaming along to the lyrics or acting like fucking hype men for their own tunes. And it's annoying because a lot of these newer kids, these new rappers and shit, don't say many words. So if you don't say many words, why not just rap the fucking words to your fucking song? So at least with Travis, he's actually doing that. But that aside, I actually put the songs in the playlist also. You know, I grabbed the set list that he used for this fucking show. I watched half of it before I went to the gym, but then I listened to the whole thing when I was at the gym, the whole playlist. And yo, Travis has some fucking bangers. He has some slappers. And also the album sounds way better live, the way it's been sequenced and where he performs it. It sounds fucking incredible. And it also affirmed to me that Travis is absolutely clear of A$AP Rocky. I know if you're A$AP Rocky, it's probably annoying to see Travis because you feel like he kind of copycatted your flow, copycatted your aesthetic, and kind of made it his own. But let's be honest, Travis is in another league to A$AP Rocky. They're not even in the same league. I feel like if they ever did the verses, A$AP Rocky and Travis, I feel like it would be really embarrassing how easily Travis would wash Rocky, because he has absolute hits. And this is not including the hits that he has recently on Utopia, which are also going to do amazing. There's a picture of flipping them, you know, Kanye wearing the fucking Jesus piece. But that aside, he has absolute hits across a pretty decent career, no, timeline that he's been out and about for. So there was a real reminder of that. And the crowd for this fucking, you know, one-off fucking live show was insane. All the fucking white kids in Italy turned up and turned out. They were rapping his lyrics word by word. Again, Rome isn't, you know, Rome isn't fucking Amsterdam. Rome isn't London. A lot of these, especially Italian kids also, it's, I don't know why, even the younger generation in Italy, not a lot of them speak English. So the fact that they fucking know the words, maybe they don't understand it, but they can repeat them back to him, was really impressive. He had the fucking whole crowd in the palm of his hands. He was performing incredibly well. He kept the energy up for 1 hour plus, right? With only one break, like all on his own, no dancers. Just fucking going for it. Like, he absolutely smashed it. And legitimately, that album sounds a lot better live. Like, it really did come across way better live. And I have to be honest, I might have to owe the guy an apology for how much I ripped the album before, because it maybe doesn't resonate as well on, you know, on your headphones. It kind of sounds like the same old Travis, but performed live, the kind of almost, you know, theatric vibe of the album and the beat switch ups and shit, it really resonated when he performed it live. I'm not gonna lie, I fucking loved it. I loved the whole entire performance, and it made me want to go and revisit the album. And it also made me want to go and see him perform it live on stage. He had these speakers stacked up like this, right, which look amazing. And if you look at them from afar, because at first I thought they looked like the kind of cardboard cutouts that Brendan Schaub used for his special Gringo Papi, right? They're kind of similar to that, like a skyline of kind of, the, you know, the city skyline. But then from afar, if you're looking at it, so it's up close to speakers, but if you're from afar, it kind of does look like a city skyline. I quite like how they did that. Really, really clever. Again, very simple, very basic. Some screens on the side projecting him you know, in full, and then obviously the crowd just in their fucking thousands out there having a fucking blast. It looked absolutely sick, man. He absolutely killed it. I legitimately can't say any more better words than this. He absolutely cleared it. Uche is saying, I don't see myself listening to an entire Travis Scott album. I just want to know which two are the bangers. Oh, two songs are the bangers. Of course, Meltdown. I love Meltdown. And then my other favorite song from the album. Oh, so Meltdown is one of my favorites. And I'm going to say, oh, Fiend. Yeah, those are two easy ones. Track seven and track eight. On the album. Oh yeah, and the Tezzo tune. Yeah, fuck man. Yeah, there's too many good ones, but if you want two off the top, I'm gonna go for track seven and track eight. Those are two really good ones. But one of my favorite ones is I know is one of my favorite songs on that album. I know. Let's actually see the lyrics quickly here. Tell me, is you still up? It's 5 a.m. I'm drunk right now. Tell me, can we still fuck? One of them, one on one, I'm in the zone right now. Tell me, am I still telling you just how much I feel right now? You said it's just the drugs, and I know. I lied to you before, like, ugh. Anyway, too much. I don't know if I can butcher the fucking lyrics, but yeah. The album is fucking banging, way better than I assumed it would be performed live. And Travis is a really, really good performer. And he's absolutely clear with ASAP Rocky. It's not even close. Again, if I'm Rocky, I'm annoyed because I'm older than him. I feel like he copied my flow. He tried to, you know, fuck Rihanna too. All this shit, I get it. But they're not in the same league. I swear to God, they're not in the same league. Travis is on another level. And it was also good to see... Kanye West come out and accompany Travis during the show. He didn't actually say too much. He said a couple of words rapping along with the songs, had his head covered for the most part, but he was out there on stage with Travis having a good time. It was good to see them hug it out, and Travis obviously saying in the mic there would be no fucking Ye, there'd be no Travis sorry without Ye, because obviously he's one of the, I think, early good music signees, and has been, you know, one someone, you know, by Kanye's side for a very long time, even though, you know, he's had Drake on fucking sicko mode and Meltdown essentially, you know, going at fucking Kanye's friends and Kanye directly and his family and shit, which is kind of gonna make you feel weird if you're Ye, the fact that you're so close to, you know, look at fucking, you know, Travis thinks you're his mentor, but then he also is not afraid of having fucking Drake come on your fucking record and absolutely smash you to pieces. You know what I mean? That's absolutely mad. But big up that. I really enjoyed it. And of course, you see them hugging out there. Big up Over and Under for the picture. You see them having a good, nice embrace there. Travis probably telling him how much he means to him and shit. Like, I'm wearing these fucking gloves because of you, man. I fucking love you, man. I fucking love white girls because of you, man. You know, he's trying to give him that fucking love. And here, of course, we've got pictures of Travis Scott's new shoes. But yeah, the show was absolutely amazing. I enjoyed it. Check out if you haven't already. Travis is a fucking sick live performer. And I don't want to hear anything different about that. I don't want to hear anything different about that. I don't actually care. I swear to God, I don't care. Travis is absolutely clear of everybody, mate. He's absolutely smashed it. That was one of my favorite sets I've seen in a very, 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 very long time. What are you guys saying here, chat, before I leave you? You're saying here, I think Travis worked with good music production and a grand hustle for artist deals. Yeah, true. Yeah, I remember that. True. Yeah. He's got one of those weird split deals, isn't it? You're right, Lucid. If the subwoofers don't thump, I don't want it. Lol, Suje. Goosebumps are my favorite. Yes, Dirty Merch. Yes, a big, big tune. Gosno says the greatest artist of all time, he said. I'm not hating. Glad to see him back, especially with all the other clown rappers today. Yeah, for sure. He raps so hard in my eyes. Yep, definitely agree with that one. Yeah, it's a great album. Only three bad songs. I don't think I agree with that. I just think the you know, the anticipation didn't really match the final result. That's the only problem with it. I don't think it's mostly a Travis thing. I think in general, in art, in, you know, in all parts of culture, I just don't think things are that great anymore. people just make sometimes mediocre art and it doesn't hit the same. But in general, I did really enjoy the performance and I feel like it breathed a new life in the album. And like I said, I made an entire fucking track listing of the fucking playlist of it. Actually, when I make the clip, I'll see if I can link to playlist, because I've got on Apple Music. I don't actually make Spotify playlists because I'm not a fucking weirdo. But anyway, I made it on Spotify. I put a little playlist together, all the songs from the fucking from the live show. So if I can make a link for it, I will add it onto the description of the podcast later on, so you can click on it yourself and add all the songs on there. But it's a pretty decent list. There's 25 songs on there, 1 hour 36, and yeah man, he absolutely killed it. I'm not gonna lie, absolutely smashed it. Fiend from the crowd went crazy. He kind of cut off the Playboi Carti part because obviously he's not there and it's his live show, but Fiend went off, man. People were going crazy when Fiend was on. Bean. Like, it's absolutely insane how much the crowd was fucking loving that song. But yeah, anyways, it was a good time. I enjoyed it. I cannot lie.